So I talked to a woman yesterday that I think was super instructive. I mean, if you're out there right now and you're at that sort of $150,000 to $300,000 in sales level, that is such a key and pivotal point, right? So whether you're doing, just taxes, just bookkeeping and accounting, or you got a mixed service firm, that is sort of a very crucial and pivotal gap, because it's right at that point where you start to realize that, maybe I didn't build this business the right way. Because at that point is where, if you don't get the pricing and the scope right, and you don't get the service offerings right in terms of the order and the pricing and the packaging, you're gonna start to tell, because you're gonna be like, I'm not making enough money to be able to hire people, but I need to hire people in order to grow. And you're in this sort of stuck null zone, and you have this sort of desire to make it all about efficiency. Okay, if I could just, organize the workflow better, if I could just do this, then if I was just more efficient, then I would be able to actually grow. That's not what it is. And it takes a lot of people a long time of just beating their head. I mean, I spoke to this woman yesterday, and I mean, just onboarding client after client, but because the fees are so low, really can't grow to another level. Can't do it. There's just too much dang work. And what you've got to start to understand is that, I mean, you don't need that many clients to be able to do big numbers. And I'm actually going to show you guys an example right now of something that has really, really clicked for me. And when I saw this, it made a huge difference. So, this woman I spoke to yesterday was at probably 250,000 in sales. So if you're at 150 to 300, this is kind of something that you need to think about. It's not just about the pricing and the packaging. It's also about how many services are you offering. Like this woman, for example, is probably missing $50,000 a year because she's referring. She's actually in the state of Florida. There's 11 states, for example, where when you refer your clients to a financial advisor, you can share in the advisory fees. She didn't know that. So she's been referring these clients over to this financial advisor. You don't need to be licensed in Florida to share in those advisory fees. He never told her that, obviously, and she didn't know it. And so it's probably $30,000 to $50,000 that's just missing in terms of net profit. So that's just one example. There's so many. But I'll show you this right here. This is a great slide that I'll show people. So you can see here, this is what I call our sales choreography. We generally like to, especially when you have a mixed service firm, start off with the tax plan. Because when you start off with the tax plan, you make the client money. In this example, you can see I say, let's say we save the person $29,000, and that's how much we save them, and then we charge them six, okay? So we save them the 29 and we charge them six. And then that's a net $23,000 worth of value. That's very key, because we don't want them to see you as just a cost, right? Just an expense. Most people see a tax accounting firm, okay, it's just an expense, right? But we want them to see, okay, hey, this person made me money. Okay. Then after that, what are all the other services we can offer? So we start off with that tax plan. Then after that, we'll go into business and individual prep. And then after that, we'll go into implementation. And a lot of people say, well, what is implementation? We typically charge for the plan. Then if the strategy's in the plan, actually implementing them. So if you go through and you're going to implement the strategy, you got to charge separately for that. And so it could be 500, it could be 1500. It depends. Some of them are thousands and thousands if it's a complex implementation where you need attorneys, third-party companies, and so on. So we will charge separately for implementation of the plan. We'll also get people on the monthly accounting. I think this woman was charging 400 bucks a month. And what you start to realize is anything less than 500 bucks a month, your business is dead. You will not be able to grow, really big and keep profitability high when you've got these $300 a month accounts. It's not gonna work. You have to do it a different way. And then we also look at, depending on if you're licensed or if you're just referring, investments and insurance. Now, the insurance you do need to be licensed for, the investments you can do in 11 states. Even if you're unlicensed, you can share in that with an advisor. That advisor is actually doing it, but you're sharing in that as what's called a solicitor, and there's very specific documents and processes. Not every company supports it, even though it is allowed. And so when you look at this, right, it is, $29,000 is how much we charge in this example, versus most people charge $3,000, $4,000, $5,000 a year. Okay. And this is for the same client. Okay. The same client. And the reason is because we save them $29,000 in taxes and we charge them the $29,000. Okay. What's key about this is, and this is what I told this woman, I said, you got too many damn clients. You got way too many clients. Let's do the math, right? 500,000 in sales. She wants to get to 500,000 in sales divided by, remember I showed you 29,000 in there? Let's say it's not 29,000. Let's say you're only able to do half of those services. You don't always get it. So you're only charging clients on average 14,500 a year. So that's 50% of the example I just gave there. So divide that by 14,500, 34 clients. If you have 34 clients paying 14,500 a year, that's 500,000 in sales. She's got way more. She's got hundreds of clients, hundreds of clients. She's got the wrong ones. And so you have this epiphany where you're like, oh my gosh, I've grown my business with the wrong client. I offered them the wrong service and I did it at the wrong price. And in order to grow, I need to change the game on that. And so if you want to go through and implement the sales choreography, if you want to work with us, I went ahead and put an application below this video. And we'll go through and show you, like, how do you pick the right client? Like, how do you define that? Like, how do you define the right price? And how do you do that if it's tax-only services or accounting-only services or if it's mixed service? And what's the order and how does that work? So how do you get the right client? How do you get the right service? And how do you get the right price? And so all these things we're going to go through. If you fill out that application, you come through on the other side. You know, we've done this with a lot of people. And, you know, these presentations that we do when people apply and go through, they're incredibly valuable. I mean, just even if you don't decide to work with us, right? So fill out the application below. The deck that we go through is about 360 slides. We'll show you, that's just one slide that we go through with people, but we'll show you all the others. And even if you decide not to work with us, it probably will be, I mean, we're right at the beginning of the year. I can tell you right now, it's probably the most valuable hour that you'll take this year. And I would recommend doing it at the beginning, because my whole goal with the way we organize our presentation at the beginning to see if people want to work with us is like, how do I make them an ROI in that appointment, even if they don't decide to work with us? So that way it's like, oh, wow, I learned so much from this appointment. Like, I should go for it because, gosh, now I know exactly what to do. It's just gonna be easier to do with you guys. So we'll map out a whole game plan for the year, which in and of itself is huge value. So if you haven't had a chance yet, you can go ahead and apply below, and my team and I will give you a call, and I'll see you on the other side.